What would it be like to travel to St. Louis to play music for a summer with the goal of honing one's guitar skills? Well, the good news is you get to find out. Because Wyatt Moeckel, after traveling to St. Louis, spent a week preparing for the musical quest ahead and was able to sit in with a local band to play some songs. Now he is seeking out opportunities to play more music and meet more musicians.
The opportunity to sit in with All Roostered Up was a great experience, but I needed to find a way to be able to play more music and play with more musicians, which is where jams come into play.
What is a jam? First, we need to start with what an open mic is. An open mic is an event where anyone can show up and perform some songs. Usually, a performer gets to play about 2 to 4 songs depending on the open mic. These events usually take place in bars and restaurants, though not exclusively. An open mic can bring around diverse groups of performers ranging from all levels of ability and proficiency. Open mics tend to have a lot of solo artists singing and playing acoustic guitar, which is where the term jam might differ. A jam usually refers to a blues jam, though there can be jams for all styles of music. At these events, a full band can sign up to play some songs, or what is more common is a full band will be assembled with people who have just shown up to the jam by themselves to play a couple of songs. This means musicians are likely to play with people they have never played with before and to play songs they have never performed, which is the magic of a jam. Many people use jam and open mic interchangeably, so maybe there isn't really a difference. They are both based around the same idea. The jam at the Broadway Oyster Bar occurs at 9 p.m. on Mondays. Unlike some jams where you put your name on a list and wait for your turn, this jam is run by the Soulard Blues Band, a band that has been around since 1978 and is comprised of some absolutely great musicians. The Soulard Blues Band typically plays for about an hour, and then they will call up musicians to sit in with them on some songs, if you talk to them ahead of time. The jam at 1860s in Soulard on Tuesday nights, starting at 9 p.m., is more of your typical open mic, as there are a lot of solo performers on acoustic guitars singing songs. But sometimes people will bring in a drum kit and some extra equipment for a full band jam. The jam at the Highway 61 Roadhouse is run by the bass player Matt from All Roostered Up. It starts at 6:30 p.m., and all you have to do is put your name and instrument down on the list. There are so many great musicians who come through this jam. It is a great place to play with and to meet a lot of different musicians. The jams around St. Louis have been a great way for Wyatt to play music live and to meet other musicians multiple times a week. These experiences are essential to understanding music and becoming a guitar legend. This is just the beginning of what Wyatt has been up to while playing music in St. Louis. Remain seated because part two of Summer in St. Louis, A Guitar Quest, More Music and More Musicians, will be out soon.